Are you? I can't hear y'all. Are you glad to be in the house of the Lord one more time? Didn't God spare your life? Watch over you all night long while you slumber and slept and woke you up this morning. Come on, somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody said, thank you, Jesus. You couldn't have been here. You shouldn't be here, but God has spared our life so we can see a day we've never seen before. So we got to give him the praise. We got to give him the praise. Look what's going on in the world around us. And we right here today giving God the praise. Like I told y'all before, First EB, you have a purpose in life. You have a purpose in life. The reason why you're not across the street in the cemetery, because you hadn't finished the work God assigned you to do. So you have a purpose in life. Don't let nobody tell you you can't do this or you can't do that. In Christ Jesus, we can do all things through Christ Jesus. Come on and clap your hands and say, yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Every time there's an election in Liberty County, the first place they start off at First African Baptist Church way down here in Riceboro, Georgia. So we have a purpose in life. So great, say, can any good thing come out of Nazareth? Can any good thing come out of Riceboro? We have great things coming out of Riceboro. Come on and clap your hands and say, yes, Lord. We even have a Miss Savannah State here in Riceboro, Georgia. Come on and clap your hands and say, thank you, Jesus. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord, for a day we've never seen before. We thank you, Father, for the many blessings you are showering upon us right now, Lord. Lord, we thank you, Father, for just being in the midst of us right now, Father. We thank you for just sparing our lives, saving us, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. You watch over all night long while we slumber and slept, Father, and woke us up this morning so we be able to go to church and praise and worship your holy and righteous name. We thank you for that, Father. We were able, Lord, to feed ourselves, put on our own clothes, Lord. We thank you for that, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. We ask you, Lord, right now to bless and anoint the church service this morning, Father. In the mighty name of Jesus, bless the families, Lord, that are going through bereavement right now, Father. Help them to realize, Lord, the earth has no sorrow, heaven cannot heal, Father. Give us the comfort we need to make it day by day. We have some sick in the shelter, Father, in the home, some in the nursing home, and some bound sick in the hospital, Father. But, Lord, I know that they call upon your holy and righteous name with an honest and sincere prayer. You will hear from heaven and heal their body, Father. We also, Lord, ask you to bless those that are behind prison walls, that they be able to hear your holy words behind those walls. And, Father, bless the families that are going through devastation in Ukraine, Father. Help Vladimir Putin realize, Father, that the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Jesus Christ our Lord. Heavenly Father, we just thank you for the good times. Thank you for the bad times. Heavenly Father, whatever we be in, you'll be able to help us out, Father. We trust your word, Lord. Heavenly Father, bless those that are traveling up and down a dangerous highway, Father. They be able to make it to their destination safe and sound. Lord, we got a word coming from you, Lord. Bless the man of God that he brings forth your word under the anointing and power of the Holy Ghost. And bless our worship leader, Father, they sing under the anointing and power of the Holy Ghost. All glory, honor, and praise belong to you, Father. And Lord, walk with us, Lord. Lead us and guide us in the direction you will have us to go, Father. We do rely, Father, your way is the only way. In your son, Jesus Christ's name, we pray. First, A.B., let's say amen. 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 Come on, clap your hands and say, yes, Lord. Let's have church first, A.B.
ought to praise his name. If a robin can do it, you can do it too. Come on, give our praise team, our devotional leaders a hand clap. Awesome. We give God praise this morning. Amen. He is truly, truly worthy this morning. Hallelujah. We bless the name of the Lord. Come on, stand to your feet. Let's give God some praise. Come on, let's give him some praise. Hallelujah. Had it not been for the Lord on our side, where would we be? We give him praise. Father, we come and we thank you this morning. We lift up your magnificent and holy name. God, we give you glory this morning. We honor you this morning, God. Father, we ask now that you will just touch this morning, that you would move, that breakthroughs would happen this morning, God, that deliverance would take place this morning, God, that salvation would manifest itself this morning with eternal life. Glorify you. Father, allow me now to go in your storehouse just for a little while. Break the bread of life with your people. This is your servant's prayer. Anoint these lips of clay. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Come on, give him another hand clap of praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You may be seated. God is good. Man, woke up this morning, it was a little cool in the room. That thing had changed, amen. Isn't that like life? Isn't that like life? 1 minute, hot. Next minute, is drastically cooler. But God, no matter what adversity comes, God is still on the throne. Y'all with me? He is still in control. And no matter what the weather may be like, you can look to the hills. Come on, somebody. All your help come from the Lord. Amen. We thank Elder Barrett, amen, for getting us started this morning. I had a little car trouble and ended up having to leave my car over at Minister Jones' place. It at least made it there, right? Amen. I got off the interstate and it went into some fail-safe mode. And so I had to coast all the way to Minister Jones. But Deacon Jeff was so gracious to come on and pick me up from over there. So keep us in prayer with these vehicles. Amen. We give God glory. But there was a time my continence would be falling and I would be concerned, but God. Come on, somebody. I've been coming this way for about 15 years. He's been getting me here too, right? Amen. He ain't going to stop now. I give him glory. I give him praise this morning. Awesome God we serve. Awesome God we serve. We are in the book of Ephesians. We're going to move over to chapter 5. Amen. Going to move over to chapter 5 this morning. We have learned that we are one in the church and that the church has been built up through the fivefold ministry for the edifying of the saints. That's the perfecting of the saints. That's to get our hearts right and our minds right to line up with what? The will of God, right? And so now we get to chapter 5 and Paul's going to tell us how we ought to live together. Come on, somebody. And before you can go out talking about helping somebody else's house, you need to get your own house in order. Come on, somebody. You gotta understand the fulfillment of Christ. And so in chapter 5, it deals with this symbolism of the marriage between Christ and the church. And also, for us people who are not married, it tells us our purpose, even as single folk. Amen? Come on. going to stand for a little bit. I'm going to read about 11 verses. I don't know if I'm going to get through 11 today. But Ephesians 5. Be ye therefore followers of God. One scripture say imitators. Followers of God as dear children. Walk in love as Christ also have loved us and have given himself for us, talking about the church, an offering and a sacrifice to God for a sweet-smelling savor. But fornication and all uncleanness or covetousness, in the old Bible say lasciviousness, let it not be once named among you as becometh saints, neither filthiness, nor foolish talking, nor jesting, which are not convenient, but rather giving of thanks. For this ye know, that no whoremonger, nor unclean person, nor covetous man, who is an idolater, hath any inheritance in the kingdom of Christ and of God. Let no man deceive you with vain words. For because of these things cometh the wrath of God upon who? The children of disobedience. Be not ye therefore partakers with them. For ye were sometimes darkness, but now are ye light in the Lord. Walk as children of light. For the fruit of the Spirit is in all goodness and righteousness and truth, proving what is acceptable unto the Lord. And have no fellowship with the unfruitful works of darkness, but rather reprove them. Amen. May the Lord bless the readers, hearers, and doers of his word. You are the light. You have been brought out of darkness. Amen. This morning, I want to talk a little bit about walking the walk. I want to talk a little bit about walking the walk. Many of us, at times, we got a good talk game. Talk game. God, something else. And you really don't know how weak your walk game is until you got to walk. Somebody gonna pray with me this morning. But what I like about the walk game is it's not the run game. I can walk from here to Bride Bay Park, but I can't run from here to Bride Bay Park. So here, Paul is telling us, for the journey is not given to the swift nor the strong, but to them who endure to the end. Many times we symbolize this life we have with Christ as athletes in a race. But here, Paul is telling us it's about how we walk, not how we run. Y'all can pray with me. We just opened a futsal court in Brunswick, and Atlanta United came down and sent some pro players, and we had some kids out there playing. And in this new game that built, this new facility, the ball hits off the wall and the ball is back in play. There's no timeout. You are just chasing that ball the whole time you're there. So I saw kids who you think were in shape. When you begin to run, it doesn't matter how in shape you are. At some point, you're going to meet your threshold where your heart rate is going to be too high. Y'all going to pray with me. And you're going to have to slow down. But when you walk, pace yourself. Y'all gonna pray with me. You can get some distance and some time in your walk. Paul is preparing the church for the long haul. Are you ready for the long haul? The long haul. That means you understand and you have the maturity to glean that if God did it for you yesterday, he can do it for you today. You have the understanding that nothing is too hard for God. And you begin to walk in that. Your talk gain lessens, but your walk gain gets stronger. I'm always leery of people who out-talk me. Anybody else like that? Anybody else feel like that? We meet somebody and Lord have mercy. They won't let you get a word in edgewise. They want to dominate the conversation. They want to guide the conversation. And finally, you just say, you can have the conversation. Many people have an awesome talk. But then you check their resume. They ain't never finished one project. They ain't stayed on the job more than 4 days. Come on, somebody. Paul is preparing the church for its purpose. He is telling them it's not all about being in front of people and moving at a fast pace. Some things you got to wait on the Lord for. Y'all gonna pray with me. If you run and you might run right past your purpose, you may miss what God has for you. And we must understand that our ways are not his ways. His ways are higher than our ways. And our God has a permissive will. Whatever you bind on earth, he'll bind in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth, he'll loose in heaven. He has a permissive will. If you want to follow a fool, he'll allow you, I wish I had somebody, to follow him all the way to the Capitol and do something foolish. Yeah. If you want to follow a fool, he'll let him take you all the way to an island somewhere and have you drink some Kool-Aid that's going to kill you. Do you hear what I'm saying to you this morning? But when you walk this walk, the Bible talks about, first of all, grace. Then it talks about love. Now, if you have a conversation, there's no love in that conversation, that might not be the person follow. If you have a conversation, there's no forgiveness in that conversation, more than likely that's not a person you need to be following. That person is not walking as light. When we give our life to God, we come out of darkness. Isn't that what the word say? Into his marvelous light. Scripture is preparing us for family living. First of all, God wants you to get your own house right. Get your own house right before you go out there trying to tell other people. Now remember, this is the classroom. This is the training ground. When we come in here, you're being trained on what you have to do out there. That's what this is. This is God preparing us to evangelize and to bring souls to the kingdom of God. This is not so Pastor Dawson can be lifted up. I have very little to do with what's going on. This is God ordained. I want you to get this now. This book book of Ephesians for First AB is God ordained. I didn't pick this out. God did for you. So I want you to get this now, because we're going to go over it and go over it. Amen. How do humans learn? When you're teaching children, they want to go on to something else. Go on to something else. But look, if you can't multiply, you can't add, you can't divide. Somebody talk to me in here. How you going to do algebra? How you going to do geometry? How you going to do trig? If you don't have the fundamental rules of multiplying fractions, for example. I thought a little bit. I had to always take them all the way back to the root. The root. So God has taken Paul here. And Paul is taking us back to the root, to the fundamental principles of love. Are you with me? All right, I'm going to hit this thing. I'm going to get on out your way. How about them Duke Blue Devils? Oh, I said something. The devil in the church. Oh. How about them Dukes? Ain't no Duke fans in here. I'm by myself. I'm all by myself. y'all gonna do Coach K like that. To God be the glory. Come on, I'm gonna hit it right here. Look, be ye therefore followers of God as dear children. That means, hey, I used to like to watch the kids after they go to church and they come home and imitate the preacher. Huh? You seen Tiger Woods, son? Now they put side by side things Tiger did not even notice. Movements, gestures, side by side. And that little boy does everything like Tiger. He wipes his nose like his daddy. And Tiger didn't know it till it showed the side-by-side. What are you saying, Pastor? Children are imitators of their parents. And guess what? If they don't imitate when they're young, they're going to find themselves. Somebody been there yet? Where you find yourself doing something like mama did it or like daddy did it? Y'all know the story of the ham bone, right? Family had a tradition, and mama would always chop the end of the ham off. And, man, that ham would be delicious. And all the young ladies, the daughters saw, was that mama always chopped that end of the ham off, and the ham would turn out perfect. So when they grew up and were married, what did they do? Chop the end of the ham. So mama came over one day for a function, and she was in the kitchen with the daughters. It was three of them. And the daughter chopped the ham bone. The mama said, "Girl, why are you chopping the ham bone off like that?" She said, "Because you did." Mama said, "I chopped it off because the pan was too short." Out of necessity. You understand? And some things we go too far with, or we don't investigate. Why? The Bible says, if any man lack wisdom, let him ask of God, who gives it liberally and upbraideth not. You got questions with why you do certain things. Even if somebody may have taught you in error, you can ask God, and God will give you the wisdom to correct yourself. Y'all praying with me? So be ye therefore followers of who? God. We're not followers of man. People have gone astray following man. He said, and walk in love. Walk in love. That means live your life in love. I've been on mouth and training. And when you begin to start dealing with your mouth, you really see where your heart is. But the good part is you can correct it by dealing with it. If I see a flaw, now I take it to the Lord in prayer. Because guess what? I can't help myself without the Lord's help. Some habits you have to get past, only God can help you and I get past them. And so when I began the mouth and training the last couple of weeks, it was a lot of training needed to be done. I had to check myself. Here, Paul is telling us to walk in love. Why? Because we ought to be imitators of Christ, as Christ also have loved us and have given himself for us an offering and a sacrifice to God for a sweet-smelling savor. When Jesus came down, he knew what he was facing. He did not know exactly what he was facing, but he knew. First of all, he had to put on this foul body. This thing that if you don't clean, will smell. But yet in this smelly body, he became what? A sacrifice to God for a sweet-smelling savor for us. Verse 3 said, but fornication and all uncleanness of covetousness, let it not be once named among you as becometh saints. This is talking about a lack of discipline in your sexual behavior. We all as kids grew up and we learned about what should be coming out of our mouths, what interactions we should be having with the opposite sex. We learned those things and we learned some discipline in those areas. But then there was always somebody a little looser. Come on, somebody. Did I put it right, Jim? A little looser. And then we might have been the one that was a little looser. Come on, somebody. Because we ain't all always been saved. None of us have always been saved. All of us have sinned. Now, I'm going to blow your mind with this. First of all, for the single people, understand the message and the goal is still the same, living for Christ. Whether you are single or whether you are married, it's still living for Christ. That's our general purpose, okay? But this is going to go into some areas of marriage. Now, when you become married, it's two sinners get married. Somebody gonna say, well, I knew the Lord, you still sinner saved by grace. Till you leave this earth, you got a sinful nature. You can't, and then you might not. But the possibility is there. It may be sin of commission, meaning you committed it, or sin of omission, meaning you chose not to do the right thing, which became the sin. But Paul is telling us, but now that you have Christ, you are the light. Husband's not saved, you the light to the husband. Wife not saved, you the light to the wife. Now, this is the tough part about marriage. When you get married, they with you and they see everything. See, nobody is so good until they want another person to know everything about them. Y'all hear, that's a lot, ain't it? I don't care if you married or not married. Guess what? Stuff come back up. Don't be telling me about me. I remember when you. Y'all know y'all do it. Y'all know who I'm talking to. Y'all don't forget nothing. Y'all remember dates, times, who all was in. Two sinners come together and are married. And now they're supposed to be the light, the thing that brighten up everything. So now I'm the light and I'm hovering over my wife. She the light and she hovering over me. If there's no grace, there's no forgiveness. All that light exposes makes people feel vulnerable. And that's why a lot of marriages don't work. Because we think we married to saints. Come on, somebody. But we get to see some of their faults. And instead of praying for them, guiding them, helping them, we use that to say you ain't what you say you are. When in reality, we are all sinners saved by grace. And we have to pray for one another. We have to institute hope for one another. And that's what Paul is telling us. Walk in love. Jesus said, I came to save the world, not to condemn the world. Are you with me? Marriage should be filled with forgiveness. Nowadays, everybody's so tough. I ain't going to take that. I ain't going to stand for that. Child, you ain't got to take that. Child, you can pay your own bill. You can do bad by. Nobody. Things can look hopeless, but God can restore hope. Are you with me? So, Paul here is getting us ready to be strong family members. He says, but fornication and all uncleanness or covetousness, let it not once named among you as become a saint. Neither filthiness, nor foolish talking, nor jesting, which are not convenient, but rather giving thanks. Let somebody else be the jester and the joke maker at somebody else's expense. But we give thanks unto God for what he has done. Verse 5, for this ye know, that no whoremonger or unclean person nor covetous man who is an idolater have any inheritance in the kingdom of Christ and of God. Paul is saying there's a reward. Even though he's saying who can't get in, he's opening the door for the children of light to get in. In other words, when we say he made a way out of no way. In our own flesh, there's no way we could get in. We could not save ourselves. But Christ came down through 42 generations. Christ took our shame upon his body on that cross. And now we have a way to the Father. But we also have a moral obligation not to be fornicators. Y'all gonna pray with me. Not to be dealing in covetousness, uncleanness, but to try to live right for God. When we begin to walk this walk, God can open doors for us. And when God begins to open doors for us, he can give us discernment. And when we get down to verse 6, you need the discernment. Because he said, let no man deceive you with vain words. For because of these things cometh the wrath of God upon the children of disobedience. Be not ye therefore partakers with them. As I close this morning, as many ways that can be interpreted. You got people who become monks, who get off the grid, who don't interact with other people. I put to you, that's not our calling. You got people who don't associate with other people at all. They go to church, they go home. That's not our calling. But Jesus sent them out two by two. Can I get scriptural on you? He sent them out two by two. He told them to go, what, live amongst the people. Y'all ain't gonna pray with me. See, it's some people that hide from people. No, if you got God in you, if you walk in the walk, you can go in a place and you can see things and experience things. But you don't have to do those things. Now, some of us, the world influences us more than we influence the world. And that's when we got to check ourselves. That's when we got to get back in this word and let this word richly dwell in us and strengthen us. But what the scripture is talking about is that you can be the light. You can be the one that can be around it. Jesus was around sinners and drinkers so much until they start calling him one. Nobody in church don't want to talk about that. Nowhere does the Bible say he drank in excess, but he did drink. Some folk want to say, no, he didn't drink the strong. No, he drunk. They ain't have no FDA back then, people measuring how much is in it and how much is not in it. When he went to people's house, it was part of social culture to put out wine. Now, we're going to be honest, because you're going to have to deal with people out there in them streets that's going to ask you honestly, what is this saying? To walk. When you get into situations that are too much, you go to God. But you don't stop living. Somebody gonna pray with me today? You don't stop living. You don't stop associating with people. You got to be the light to those people. That's your calling. Me and John, we ain't perfect. But every time I see John going to give you a sermon about how good John be out preaching me. Am I right about it? Yeah. The Lord has done something for you. You have a word. Don't sit on your word. He said, we are saved by the blood of the Lamb and the words of our testimony. That's where Paul's trying to take us. He wants us to be the church. He don't want us to be the fake church. He don't want us to be the hypocritical church. He don't want us to be the phony church. He guess what? The church ain't perfect. When he said, I'm coming back for a church without spot or wrinkle, that's not perfection. That's trust. That's faith in God. The only thing that can give you spot, have you without spot or wrinkle, is you look to the hills. That's all he asks you to do. That you look to the hills from whence all your help come from the Lord. That's all he's asking us to do. That's why I can preach this morning. Because I trust him. Do you trust him this morning? Walk the walk. That means love in spite of. I deal with families. And families these days are far from perfect. The things you think should be a priority are not a priority. The things you know should not be a priority are the priority. And they will lie to your face. That's what we're dealing with. Very little standard. Very little. But how do we break through? Walk in love. Love covers. What the word say? Talk to me, church. A multitude of sin. Everybody stand on your feet. Listen. When you're getting ready to go to work, and God is feeding me nuggets for you. God is feeding the practical application for you. Remember, we're in mouth and training. Mouth and training. Pulpit to the door. Forgiveness. Forgiveness. That's the next element to come out of our mouth. Come out of our heart. Forgiveness. Start with yourself. Ooh, thank you, Lord. You know, some of us carry baggage from 50 years ago. You can't change that mess. Start with self today. Forgive yourself. I was out with a friend one day. We were in Atlanta, preacher friend. We went to get some lunch. And the place was a bar and grill. The waitress came to the table, beautiful young lady. But he saw fallen continents. He saw her continent had fallen. He saw something in the windows. You know, eyes out a window to the soul. He saw something in her eyes and he said, come here, baby. He said, I want you to go in the bathroom. I want you to tell yourself, I forgive you. I want you to tell yourself, I love you. He said, when was the last time you told yourself that you broke down. Oh, man, she went to crying. How did you know? How did you know? Mama had turned her back on her. Brother had turned her back on her. She was to move her stuff out of the house when she got off of work that day. First, you got to forgive yourself. I don't know how many of us aren't where we thought we would be at this stage in our life, but let it go. Let it go. Let it go, y'all. Let it go. Let God have it. Let him free you. Ooh, thank you, Jesus. Let him set you free. See, it's hard to walk when you got an 80-pound backpack on. This is how you walk. When you should be walking. talking like this. Let it go. Give it to God. Let's bow our heads. Father, we come now. This is a serious moment in this service. Father, we've been dealing with our own hearts and our own tongues. And they say you can't tame that tongue. Say he's hard to tame. Say he's a small vessel, but he's hard to tame. So, Father, we got him in training. Father, we're digging to the heart now, God. Help us to walk the walk. Strengthen us on every hand, God. Help us to illuminate when we walk in the room. Help us to illuminate when we have individual conversations with people. Help love to come out of our mouths, not condemnation. The Bible said the evil of the day is sufficient within itself. Help us to fight the battle now. Help us to fight the good faith battle. We glorify you. Somebody needs you. Somebody needs to repent. Somebody needs to say, I yield, I yield. Somebody just needs to know that you're there. Touch today. Touch family members. Touch today. Father, we pray for the Louder family right now. Brother Lewis today. Please be with their children today in this hour of bereavement. Strengthen them now on every hand. We need you now, God. We bless your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. There may be somebody here who doesn't know Christ and the pardons of your sins. Who, Jesus? Today is a good day to be saved. We open the doors of the church. This is the invitation of Christian discipleship. That means disciplined one. That's why we're going through what we're going through. God is preparing us to be disciplined, to be disciples. He sent the disciples out two by two. He sent them to live among the people. He didn't tell them to go be hermits. He didn't tell them to ignore their brothers who need a word. But he said, you go live among them. He said, now if they don't receive the word, you go to the edge of what? The city. You don't stand in their house and shake the dust. That's vengeful. He said, you go to the edge of the city. Shake the dust. Don't say nothing. Shake the dust. Keep it moving. Go to another house. Live among them. Jesus loves people. You gotta love if you're gonna serve. You gotta forgive if we're gonna serve him. Take a seat. Hallelujah.